Hey there friends, I wanted to do a video on the new EOS R and whether or not you should buy it. I was really just totally excited about this camera, but I'm not sure it's for me now. I was on the street talking to Barb Beebe, downtown Cory, Pennsylvania. We got talking about this camera and other cameras and what one to go to from where you're at right now. And I'm gonna walk you through this little sheet that I made up full of prices and stuff to just help you consider what camera is the next buy for your bag. So let's jump into it and hopefully this helps you. Okay, so as I looked at this new EOS R5, it is amazing, but it's expensive for a lot of us that are, you know, kind of pro, semi-pro level. And a lot of the people that I deal with, that I talk to, a lot of my friends are not needing a $4,000 camera at this point. And a lot are not doing video and photography at the same time. The thing that this camera really helps you do is shoot 120 frames per second and very high quality. And that was lacking to have that and to have dual cards. So you're shooting to two cards at the same time. So let me walk you through some of my logic and why you might consider waiting on buying the new EOS R5. And so let me walk you down through the prices that I've come up with here. The EOS R5 is about $3,800, $3,899, so basically $3,900. If you're gonna add a 24-70 RF lens, that's gonna be $2,200. If you're gonna add a 50 millimeter RF lens, that's also gonna be about $2,200. So you're gonna have, starting out, just getting started, having the lenses for that, $8,300 to get started. Now, the thing you could do is buy adapter and put that on there and use your old lenses, but I hate to do that. I hate to add something to the mix and use an adapter and add the lenses to it. I'd rather just have the lenses that were made for that. But that is an option that would lower the cost. But still, the camera is $3,900 and that's a lot of money. So then I think the second option that you have, if you're shooting pro photography and you wanna do some pro video, is the 5D Mark IV. Now I own two 5D Mark IVs and I absolutely love them. There's hardly anything that I personally cannot shoot on those. I also have C-Log on those cameras, so I can shoot in C-Log. I can shoot to two cards and that's been very helpful. If you buy that right now, it's $2,600. If you wait for some deals, I was able to pick some up for about $2,200 with some freebies added in. You can buy a 50 millimeter 1.2 for $1,300 or the 24-70 for about $1,600. So all in on that camera, you can have somewhere around $5,500. So that's right away gonna save you about $3,000 to have a really pro level camera to use for a lot of these shoots. The next option is the 6D Mark II. I really built my business on the 6D Mark II. It is a fantastic full frame camera that shoots great resolution, but it only has one card. And so at some point you gotta say, do I wanna risk my business and my reputation shooting on just one card? So for the 6D Mark II, here's how much you're gonna have into it. It's about $1,400 if you buy it new. You can buy it used and save even more. You can get a 50 millimeter 1.4 for $330. You can get a 24-105 F4 for about $1,100. All in about $2,800 for that camera if you buy everything new, and perhaps you already have some lenses that would go with this. Now, this is a very interesting play with that, right? Is that you could go this way with the 6D Mark II, or you could consider the new EOS RP, which I believe replaces the 6D Mark II. It gets you into the RF lenses. You can buy a 35 millimeter RF lens for $450. So I do think if you're just getting into this new mirrorless and you really want to go mirrorless, then, and you don't have a lot of money to spend, you can start with the RP without jumping all the way into the EOS R5 or the EOS R. So just a couple options to think through. I think for a lot of people, if you're shooting a T7i, for instance, it's a crop sensor camera, go to the 6D or go to the EOS RP and start shooting there. Start shooting full frame. It's gonna add a lot for you. You're gonna love it, but it doesn't cost you a ton of money. So should you go mirrorless? The answer is it depends. For me and my business, I have decided to stay put with the DSLRs right now. I have the 5D Mark IV, I have two of them, I absolutely love them, and my backup cameras are the 6D Mark II. But I still have the dual cards that help me make sure that I'm delivering a professional product. I'm protecting my client's assets. Cause you imagine if you're shooting a wedding, you just don't want to lose a single picture. And we work very hard to protect those assets. So this was my logic. I looked at the numbers. I said, I don't have $8,200 to spend right now. That's my goal for next year. Goal for 2021 is to upgrade to the EOS R5. But for right now, I'm staying put with the 5D Mark IV. And I think maybe you should consider that too. If you're a notch below that and you're not ready to spend the $2,600 for the 5D Mark IV, then consider getting the 6D Mark II, fantastic camera, or the EOS RP. If you're somewhere in between of all that, you could even pick up the EOS R, especially if you're doing video. Just remember, you're only getting one card in that camera and you hate to lose it all. I hope this helps. Ask some questions, start some discussion below. I'll answer those questions on the feed that way, and it'd be fun to be a part of that discussion. Maybe I'm missing something. Maybe I should go out and spend $8,200 on a kit that would help me get started mirrorless, but I'm gonna wait. Let me know what you're gonna do.